Hey guys, it's Vaughn, and I am here with a grocery store haul video. I asked you guys on Instagram just today, see if I can pull it up, asked you guys if you wanted me to do a grocery store haul, do like a poll on it. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it looks like the majority of you said you wanted to see it. For everyone who said they didn't, I was cracking up. I always crack up when I do like the yes, no polls and people are like, no. I remember one time I did a poll and I was like, you guys wanna see me try on this wig? And you guys were like, no. It was so funny. So anyway, I went to Target and Whole Foods just to replenish groceries and get things around the house that I needed. And so I just wanted to share it with you guys. The total that I spent on everything was about $300. So this is not one of those like budget friendly type of hauls. It was really just me getting a lot of the stuff that we needed. I've been traveling in and out, me and Ann both. So we really hadn't gone grocery shopping in a really long time. So that's why it's so much. And I usually just go, I have like no set schedule. I'll just go when we need things. And so yeah, let's get started. So I'll start with the Target stuff. And I'm just in my kitchen, you guys, real casual. I just threw my camera up real quick, trying to get this stuff unpacked so I can put it in the refrigerator and freezer and whatnot. So I'm just gonna kind of run through everything. So for starters, this first Target bag, I just got some almond milk creamer for my coffee. I don't know if you guys can see my Keurig back there, but I use a Keurig for my coffee every day. It's just so much easier and I get the perfect amount of coffee. I don't like making like a big old pot because I don't really drink more than one cup. So that's perfect for me. So I usually get my almond creamers. I get the different flavors just because it just adds a little bit of zest. Oh, email. So this one is like a caramel flavored one. Next I got Anne some goodies. These are just for her little lunches. These are little chicken nuggets. I get the ones that are like natural, like made with vegetables and blah, blah, blah. Anne was pretty much vegan for most of her life. I mean, she's like almost a year and a half now. She's vegan for most of the time, but her tastes are expanding. She's becoming more curious about other flavors and stuff. So I'm not gonna hold her back. I'm just gonna give her what she wants in a safe way, of course, but she really doesn't like chicken. So this is something I'm trying new. And then for the other one I got is just one of these Totally Rockin' Tots Russet Potato and Cauliflower. I'm just gonna see if she likes these. I just got some organic strawberry and banana fruit blend. This is frozen fruit. I use this to make like my little breakfast bowls. You could also use this for smoothies and stuff. I don't really make smoothies, so I don't like them that much. But I do like to make like the little frozen blend, and you can put like your granola, your coconut flakes, your cocoa nibs, all that kind of stuff. You can make like a breakfast bowl with them. Next from Target, I just got some 100% whole wheat bread. Anne likes to have this for breakfast in the form of toast. I also got her some macaroni, instant macaroni. You know, I cook for Anne a lot, but a lot of the instant stuff I get just because it's easier for us, like when we're on the go or like when her nanny's here. Like I don't expect her to like stand over the stove and like create all of these elaborate meals. So I like to just have something easy. And then Anne let me know yesterday she likes Oreos, so I got a new pack of Oreos. This bag, shout out to Target, I just got some La Marca Prosecco. This is one of my favorite types of Prosecco. It's very affordable. Usually when I go grocery shopping, that's when I also get liquor. So I do have some liquor in these bags. It's this big bag of like a variety pack of potato chips and stuff. Not really for me, but Aunt Nanny really likes chips. And then one more thing I got was just this gallon of whole milk for Anne. She's not really feeling the almond milk lately. So seventh generation bacterial disinfectant spray for Anne's room. I pretty much clean the house with whatever cleansers I have, but for Anne's room in particular, I like to use cleansers with like, you know, safe ingredients, nothing harsh. I get all the organic safe stuff specifically for her room, and I'm kind of transitioning that methodology to the other parts of the house, but definitely her room is where I kind of started feeling that way because I didn't want to clean like bleach or like any harsh ammonias and stuff. But like I said, that's starting to like spill over into like the other parts of the house. So we're getting there. I got some of this finished Powerball dishwasher pellets for our dishwasher. And then last thing from Target, I just got some Goldfish crackers. These are the baby ones. Anne really likes them as a snack. Strawberries, these are just some Driscoll's strawberries. I use these for, you know, like my fruit bowls and stuff for breakfast, but also this is Anne's favorite fruit. And then finally for Anne, she likes yogurt, but only particular ones. Like she just doesn't eat any yogurt because it doesn't agree with her stomach. So she really likes these Wee yogurts, non-GMO. It's French style yogurt, so it's by Yoplait, and then they have like the real fruit at the bottom of these. So this one is strawberry. I got her a coconut one and then also a lemon one. All right, that is it for Target. I'm just gonna clear space here and move on to Whole Foods. All right, so from Whole Foods, here's what we got. I just picked up a couple of bundles of kale. I use the kale for my juicing, and then also I just like kale sauteed. It's so delicious. Yeah, organic cherry tomatoes, because this goes in like almost anything I eat. Great for salads, great for cooking, so good. I like to get bell peppers in different colors and stuff because I like it to be pretty. It makes me enjoy my food better when it's pretty. So I got a red one and a yellow one. Get this over a little bit more, okay. And I got some bok choy. Next, I got some seasonings. I'm a huge fan of spicy foods, you guys. So I got some habanero seasoning. This is just an organic seasoning pack. What I like about these is that it's just easy. So instead of having to think through blending different seasonings to get the desired flavor, you can get something like this where they've already gone through all of that guesswork for you. And so it's pretty much a prepared seasoning that is still organic and very delicious. This other one is just a sesame ginger blend. I like using this one for like some of my more Asian flavors, my oriental flavored dishes. So I can see me definitely sprinkling this on top of like a kale salad, a warm kale salad, right? Where you kind of just saute it a little bit with some sesame oil, some soy sauce, or maybe like even on my noodles, like when I do like my udon noodles or like my rice noodles, or even my ramen. Next, I just got a baby eggplant, a whole onion. I got some red chilies because, like I said, I'm a huge fan of spicy. Gotta have it. If I don't have it, I'm extremely bored. All right, next are two of my favorite things in the world, and that would be two avocados. My husband just bought some avocados, so I didn't need to get like a whole bunch more, but I definitely wanted to get two extra ones that were not ripe at all yet, because once I'm done eating those, I want to be able to reach right for another one. So there's no lag time with avocado. Like, I have to constantly have it in the rotation. And I got like a little bundle of Brussels sprouts. I love roasting these, and I like having them as part of like a veggie bowl or something like that. Brussels sprouts are so good. Next, I just got a little lime. These are just the things that I always pick up when I'm in the grocery store. Like, even if I don't have like a meal planned out, like I have to just get avocado, I have to get lime. Like, it's like when you get toilet paper or like dishwashing liquid. This is just a garlic clove, because I'm always cooking with this. And then I just got a new, I just like re-upped on my basmati rice. I'm always getting basmati or jasmine. And then I got some Kalamata olives because I want to do like a Greek kind of veggie bowl thing. We're almost done. I just got some spinach fettuccine noodles. I just got a couple sea salt seaweed snacks. Usually I get these from the Asian market, but whenever I'm in Whole Foods and I see them, I'll just grab them. Normally I eat them on the way home. I don't know how these made it home. Some garbanzo beans. I want to try to cook some from scratch. Never tried these before in this way. I usually get them out of the can or just kind of already prepared. So this will be my first time making them, so I'm excited. I also got one of Ann's favorite things, which is some applesauce. This is just the 365 Everyday Value brand, and this one is unsweetened and it's organic and all that good stuff. Usually I make Ann's applesauce from scratch because it's so easy, but sometimes I'll just get like the little individual packs just because it's, you know, it's simple for her nanny to just kind of go and grab one out of the fridge for her. I try to have her eat like a variety of different things every time she eats, so it's never just like one thing. And so that is just an attempt to try to get her to be more open to trying different things, but we'll see. I got some baby spinach and some more alcohol. Okay, this is just a beer that I want to try. It's an ale brewed with graham crackers, cocoa nibs, vanilla, and natural flavor. This is a 10% ABV. It's a craft beer though, which is the only kind of beer I drink, and by craft beer, it's just like, I get beers from like microbreweries and things. I don't usually get like your mass-produced, typical Heineken, Guinness, that kind of stuff. I don't drink that stuff. Not that there's anything wrong with it, I'm just a little bit more particular about my tastes, and I just have to really be almost entertained by my beer. You know, I don't want to just drink it just to get tipsy. I want to like enjoy it and like all that. So I consider myself to be a pretty thorough beer snob. My favorite types of beers are like stouts that have been aged in bourbon barrels. So the barrels are soaked in bourbon type of thing, and the beer is aged in those barrels. So those are my favorite types, but I'm trying to branch out a little bit more and try some different ones. So by this being an ale, this is kind of different for me. This is from Pipeworks Brewing. I think I heard about this beer, so I'm gonna give it a shot and see if I like it. And my favorite types of wines are red wines, dry reds. And so I picked up this wine from Whole Foods, and it's just a death metal red. I have no idea what this is going to be like. This is something new as well. All right, we're at the last bag. loving it. You guys see my tulips here that my husband got me. I love having fresh flowers in the kitchen. All right, so we've got some shiitake mushrooms. I just grabbed like two handfuls of them. I love shiitake mushrooms. I put it in my ramen. I sauteed it just with like some kale or spinach. I put it on my rice. Like, I love mushrooms, which will explain why I got this one in addition to the shiitakes. These are just portobellos. They're just like little baby bellos. So I'll cut these up and cook them in a similar way. Next, I got just a bundle of grapes. I got some white quinoa. I got some parma, which is like a vegan substitute for Parmesan cheese. I was about to get some nutritional yeast. That's why I was over there. So I'm gonna try this. This is the first time of me trying this. Next, I got some Himalayan pink sea salt. This is a replenishment item because I always have like my sea salt in the grinders and stuff. And so I have a sea salt already, but I ran out of the Himalayan pink one, so. And then I got some barley peas and lentils, just like a little blend here. I want to try this with my veggie bowls and whatnot. And I've been talking a lot about veggie bowls. You guys are probably like, what the hell is that? Let me show you guys an example. So like when I talk about veggie bowls, it's like stuff like this. You know, when it's just like a rice bowl with veggies in there and just all this delicious goodness, like that kind of stuff, you know? So these are the kind of things that I'm gonna be making with these groceries that I got. And I follow like a lot of different vegan Instagram pages and stuff. I probably follow like maybe about 10. I'll put some of my favorite ones in the description box if you guys wanna check out so you can get some inspiration. But normally what I'll do before I go to the grocery store is just kind of scroll through my favorite feeds and then just like based on the pictures, I'll kind of see if I have a taste for any of that stuff. And then I'll let that kind of guide my grocery store event. So that's basically what I did today. I just got some pad thai rice noodles, pine nuts. I like to garnish with these. I also got a can of organic black beans. Then I got these butternut spirals. Whenever I've tried to cook these, I always overcook them because you think about it like you do noodles and they don't need to cook that long. They just need to warm a bit. When you overcook them, it becomes mush. And then lastly, okay, I got some fingerling potatoes. These are Russian banana. So you guys, that's it for my grocery store haul. And let me know what you thought about this one. That was really casual. Like, I just got on like my grocery store run outfit. But I just wanted to pop in because you guys did say that you wanted to see it. So I'm like, you know what? Let me just film it now before I put everything away. So this was fun to share, kind of like a show and tell type of thing. And I hope you guys enjoyed it. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye.
Yo, one glass of Patron to smash, then it's on, and I dash right back to the pad where I zone. Got a stash collection, double packs.